Hello, I'm Mitchell from SheetGo, and today I'm going to teach you how to use the Google Finance formula in Google Sheets. So the Google Finance formula helps us to get an insight of stock prices and compile relevant stock information on your spreadsheet, which means that this is a very useful formula for data analysts. So in this case, I want to know the lowest, the highest, and the last month stock prices of Apple. The ticker of Apple is AAPL, so that's why I put in AAPL instead of Apple. So I'm going to use the Google Finance formula. And every company does have another ticker. So if you want to find out which is the ticker of a company, you need to search for it throughout the web. So I'm selecting AAPL. And I want to know the lowest stock price. But first, I will put on the AAPL into dollar signs, so I could drag it to the right without changing the formula. If you find this difficult, this video is based on a blog post, so if you want to read more, please click on the link down below in the description, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And secondly, I want to know the lowest value, so that's why I'm putting on low. And put it into brackets, and as you can see, the lowest stock price of today is 183.66. So I'm dragging it to the right, as I want to know the highest stock value as well. And the highest stock value is 186.22. So now I want to know last month's stock prices, which are a bit more difficult, but we are using the same formula. So I'm using the same equation, Google Finance, same ticker, which is AAPL, which corresponds to Apple. But this time, I want to know price. So price corresponds to stock price, and I want to know the stock price of Apple. So price, comma, and I'm going to use the today formula. So we have made a video about the today formula, and it is based on a blog post. So if you want to read more about the today formula, please click on the link down below in the description. So I'm going to use today, and I'm going to use today minus 30, which means last month's stock prices. So minus 30, put it into brackets, and as you can see, the Google Finance formula successfully determined the stock prices of last month. Well, why there are only 19 stock prices? Not all of the stock prices are updated in the weekend. So some of the stock prices aren't in this formula. So that's why there are only 19 stock prices instead of 30. So this is how I use the Google Finance formula. I want to thank you for your time. And if you liked the video, please put the thumbs up. Goodbye.